This is Match Game 74, production number 0183. Air date to be announced, VTR 32974. Get ready to match the stars. Alan Ludden. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Joyce Bulifant. Richard Dawson. And Fannie Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Reber.
Yeah.
Yes,
that's an
excellent.
Brett is not ready.
Gone funny. Have you noticed?
I heard they were going to do a remake of Gone with the Wind.
Yes.
So I had Edie fix my hair this way.
Looks pretty.
Does she look like Marianne Mobley to you?
No, I look like Vivian Lee in the good days.
You look like Clark
after
Gable
the fire.
On a bad day,
right? What did you say?
He said you look like Clark Gable on a bad day.
You're so mean.
Truthful too, darling.
He's sweet. He's okay. Well, you look to me as if you're all ready. So we'll greet our celebrity over here on this side. Here's our current champ, Robin Barrett.
Yeah. How are you, Robin?
Robin won one game, and she's got $100 to her credit, and she's about to have a go at over $5,000 in our Big Money Super match here. Are you ready for that?
I sure am.
Okay, we'll do that right after we do a little business with you, so you stick around for that. Here we go. Robin Barrett, let's see how you're going to do here now in the Big Money Super match. You know how this goes. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank Arthur. Now, the answer that audience gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250. If you match that bottom one, you get $100. A little help is allowed from our celebrities. Choose three, one at a time.
Richard.
Richard Dawson. How do you fill that in there?
King Arthur.
King Arthur, he says.
To the king.
To the king.
Let's fight till I'm a horse.
All right, sir. Don't get carried away.
Yeah,
he is
about
British,
to do the speech.
You know. All right.
Alan.
Alan, what's his name?
After King. President.
Queen.
Let's try President Arthur.
President. Who was President Arthur?
Well, he was president of the Rotary Club in Seattle.
Poor Betty White. I never thought I'd feel sorry for her.
That's your answer, President Arthur.
No, I not can't. Only that, he voted for her.
Me, I was so convinced it was King Arthur.
Yeah.
I haven't got a Lord Arthur.
I'm afraid that won't wash, Alan.
Yes, sir. President
okay, President Arthur is the answer that we have to go with, and that's it. All right, one more.
Kinds of Arthurs.
Joyce.
Oh, I'm so glad you asked me because I have two children named Mary MacArthur and Charles MacArthur, so I have to go with MacArthur. Well, as in general, not Mary and Charles, but
MacArthur is what you want to say.
Yes.
Any MacArthur.
Any MacArthur.
Could be like Sam MacArthur or
Sam?
President
How
MacArthur.
How about my dear friend me?
Okay.
President MacArthur.
All right. So you've got King Arthur, MacArthur, and President Arthur.
Now, that's a great set of choices.
You've got 2.5 answers there. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own if you like, but we call for an answer now.
King.
King. Yeah. All right. We are looking for King Arthur. May we see the $100 response, sir?
President!
B. Arthur. That brilliant actress, B. Arthur,
you
who plays Maud. And a friend of yours, yes. All right, we're still looking for King Arthur. Is he under the $250 response?
President.
No, MacArthur is, though. That's the one that Joyce gave you. Very good. Well, you're getting close, so this may be it. Hold on to your hat. Ready? All right. King Arthur, Sir Lancelot here calling. Are you under the $500 response?
Yes.
Congratulations.
they think of the president, Arthur?
I don't know.
That audience was
they've
out
never
of
been to Seattle.
That's right.
Okay, so it's King Arthur it is for $500 for you. That means you're now playing for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Now, to collect the $5,000, you must match one celebrity head-to-head. It has to be an exact match. Choose one now, if you please.
Richard.
Richard again gets ready to write. You face me. Here is the $5,000 question, Richard. Happy blank. Happy blank. All right, he's finished. Now we want to know how you fill in that blank. Happy blank.
Birthday.
You say birthday? Okay, the audience seems to think that that is a good choice. We'll find out if you match Richard now by asking him to expose his card. May we see your response, sir, for $5,000?
There's a big hit TV show. Yeah, called Happy Days, which was, of course, before I was born. So I wrote Born Day or Birthday.
Congratulate you, Robin. You now have a total of $5,600, and in a moment or so, you'll play another game after we pass along this message of interest to one and all. Here it is.
GSN presents...
Someone showed me a single-spaced typewritten list of all the celebrities who had been on Match Game, and it's a formidable list. Betty White, Burt Reynolds, Kitty Carlisle, Joe Garagiola, Steve Allen... You know, we had them all.
Stay tuned for more of That 70s Hour on GSN.
Everybody came and bowed and paid the respect and kissed my ring.
Today's consolation prizes are the Gemini All-Floor Sweeper by Bissell. Sweeps any surface you can walk on right up to the baseboard. No cords or attachments required from Bissell. And the InSinkErator Hot Water Dispenser gives you 190-degree water at your kitchen sink like having a tea kettle always ready from InSinkErator. And Profile, with its own great flavor from a special formula of cracked wheat and wheat germ, just right for toast. Profile, it's a matter of taste. There'll be more challenges to the stars when Match Game 74 continues in just a blank.
Hello there. Now, we're going to start another game. To do that, we've got to welcome a new player, and we do so with a great deal of pleasure. Here is Michael Herbs.
Thank you.
How are you, Michael?
Pretty good, Gene.
Where are you from?
From Los Angeles. I'm a local fella.
You are?
Yep.
Michael is a local fella from Los Angeles here. Tell us a little more about yourself.
Well, I'm a communications consultant for a Fortune 500 company, and married, have two kids. Yeah. Angela and Kenny, and they're probably watching. Angela's 9 and Kenny's 8.
Yeah.
How you guys?
Do they like this show?
Love it.
They watch it often?
They think you're the greatest.
Well.
Honey matches.
Well, I thank you for that. Good luck to both of our players. Shall
thank
we
you.
Begin?
Why not?
All right, I'll push a button and ask our challenger, Michael, to make a selection.
A.
He wants A, and this is a new game, folks. Here we go. The president was
Arthur?
I told you that he was being around, yeah.
The president was flabbergasted when he saw blank streaking across the White House lawn.
Flabbergasted.
You got your own game going out there in the audience, have you?
The White House
president was flabbergasted when he saw blank streaking across the White House lawn. I've got my answer in my head.
I've got my answer.
Yeah, we're all finished here. We're waiting for...
Charles gets slower and slower.
Let's
I think he's getting old.
Him.
I think it's premature senility.
He's not that old.
I'm 26.
William!
And a terrific liar. Okay, all finished over there, Michael, so we ask you. The president was flabbergasted when he saw blank streaking across the White House lawn.
I'm really embarrassed because I want to think of President Nixon's wife, and I can't right off, but his wife.
His wife, Pat.
Pat, there you go. Thank you.
Yeah, how quickly they forget. A lot of people are trying to forget too well. He says Pat was streaking across the White House lawn. What say you?
Well, Michael, I tried to think of Pat streaking across the White House lawn, but I couldn't think of it. It really was a picture I couldn't conjure. And
you thought of President Arthur, why wouldn't you think of Pat?
But I could think of another lady who has been in the White House, not much lately, but she's been there, Martha Mitchell.
Martha Mitchell. There's a little logic to that.
A little.
Okay, Brett.
Well, you know, he sounded just like President Nixon when he said, I can't think of it. Not only can she streak, honey, I've seen her streaking all over town. Pat.
Pat Mitchell. There's one for you, Michael. Charles, you drew a picture.
No, this is the new Polish President Arthur Stamp. Our beloved President Farquhar P. Arthur. Well, I don't know their names either. The Supreme Court streaking. I think that's more fun.
Can those nine old men streaking get in? Is that the way? That's Justice Douglas. Well, he's in good shape.
That's not called snailing. That's streaking. It's called snailing.
That's right, snailing.
It's called Show Tim Conway, really, isn't it?
I think that Pat's been seen in my neighborhood lately, too.
Pat it is. President was flabbergasted when he saw blank streaking across the White House lawn, Richard.
There's only one answer, isn't Just a minute, my secretary must have erased this.
And now the good news. Pat!
Okay, now Fannie.
Before I give you my answer, it was a first lady. It was Lady Bird, and she was interviewed by the press after she did it, and she said, I streaked first to a bush. Then I streaked to a tree. And then I ended up behind a shrub. First lady.
There it is, the first lady. Another man. Right. Very well done.
I like my friends.
Okay. I love it when you do that. Now, here we
she
go
doesn't.
With your editor. Not many people know this there, but Julia Child got expelled from cooking school for blanking the galloping gourmet. Julia, wherever you are.
I lost one of Fanny's earrings when I went streaking to show you about Justice Douglas and all them other kids.
Well, we'll find it. It's around
Anybody
here somewhere.
Anybody finds a solid gold earring worth a
Would you mind
dollars?
Playing the game and not stop talking about the earrings?
Did you read in the paper that most airline pilots find it, you know, have a problem about President Arthur Airport? They can't find it.
Nobody ever heard of President Arthur.
One of my favorite presidents.
It was wonderful.
Julia Childs was doing what to whom? Galloping gourmet.
Julia Childs got expelled from cooking school for blanking the galloping gourmet.
Okay.
Please take your time, though.
Your attention span is getting shorter, Alan.
Well, he's only three and a half.
All right, I'm 26.
Okay, they're all finished, so we'll call on. What's that?
I didn't hear the question.
You didn't hear the question.
There's huge laughing.
I'll give you a very personal, close reading.
Okay.
Not many people know this, but Julia Child got expelled from cooking school for blanking the galloping gourmet.
Cooking.
For cooking the galloping gourmet?
God.
Well done, medium or rare? How do you want your galloping gourmet?
According to how old you are.
As if that lady were a little weird to think of cooking a galloping gourmet.
Well, that's a possible answer.
And she is a little weird, I guess.
Yes.
But aren't we all?
Ah, there it is. You've got cooking. One for you. What do you say?
Well, I don't know what happened to me, but I just kept thinking about Alan and Betty's marriage. So I said, resting with.
Resting with. And they expelled her. Okay, Brett.
Your hair just dropped.
Yes.
I love you.
Yes. Charles.
I said, and I hope it matches basting, the galloping gourmet.
Is basting cooking? Yes. Okay. You couldn't baste without cooking, could you? What did you say she got expelled for?
Expelled for? Well, I think since he's galloping that she probably was riding him, piggyback. Piggyback.
You said that?
Piggyback.
Oh, piggyback riding. I see.
What'd you think?
The galloping gourmet. Okay. Very interesting. All right, Richard.
It's okay, Joyce.
I happen to know.
Why?
She was expelled for assaulting him.
That's true. That's true. All right, Fanny?
Julia Childs served him with a wonderful tomato sauce and a flaming banana, and she cooked him.
Cooked him. This has been one of the most interesting round ones we've played in a long time, and with an interesting score in addition, 4-3 in favor of the challenger. Round two coming up in a moment or so, but first we've got this for you. Can't find the earring, but we've been looking for the earring all during the commercial. Anybody find it? Wayne, is that your earring or? Well, our cameraman wears an earring, but what the heck, it's a...
Someone's found it, and they haven't turned it in.
No. Listen.
What?
Give her the earring. Is that it?
Yeah, both of them.
I can't hear what you say because of the earring in my ear. There. I hope
that's
you're
it.
Very happy.
Is that one or
that's
two?
One. They're my earrings. Brett barred them.
We've still lost one. Is that it? Well, we'll find it
who
during the next.
Who lost his contact lens? No.
With the game
folks.
It's a serious show.
Okay.
Now, first I got to push this button. Oh, look at that. It works. Now, Michael, would you make a selection, please?
Try again.
A, all right. Last time you matched four celebrities, and that means you will only be playing now with Alan and Charles.
Oh, God bless her.
Well, we could look for the earring then.
Yes, sir. No. With all the shortages these days, robbers no longer say your money or your life. Now they say your money or your blank.
I've lost my watch, too.
There's a thief among us.
No, it fell off. Well, I don't mind about the watch, but
it's
your earring.
I don't see the earring. All right, the two gentlemen are ready. Michael? With all the shortages these days, robbers no longer say your money or your life. Now they say your money or your blank. Because of the shortages of various things today, now they say your money or your... Shh, no help. Well, we appreciate your enthusiasm, but you may be giving them a rotten answer, you know. We have to call for an answer now, Michael.
Why don't we try wife?
Your money or your wife?
Yeah. There's no shortages.
Yes, as you'd get to that question,
yeah.
Honey.
Yeah.
Alan, he says wife. Your Michael, money or your wife?
Michael, you didn't hear about the shortages.
I
there's
heard
no
it, but I didn't get it.
Yeah. I see. All okay, right. Gasoline, I
gasoline
said.
Gasoline would be a good answer. Charles?
Yeah! Yes.
Yes, he did. Okay. All right. Now we'll go to this question here. You must match one celebrity to stay in the game. Two, however, will win the game. Charles, we got Charles' answer. He had gasoline.
Okay. Don't take any notice of him.
Okay.
What do they know?
42 to score. Here we go.
Hey, what about Charles?
Audience, let me run the show, all right? Just scream and holler and laugh and do all that, and I'll keep the show going. Here.
What's the matter? If you were listening to it. Well, last time.
Thank you. Yeah, I love you. You're all right. Last time, Robin, you matched Alan, Charles, and Fannie, so the three of you will lay out.
All right.
Sir Lancelot ate so much at the royal banquet, he needed blank to get out of his suit of armor. All right. Sir Lancelot ate so much at the royal banquet, he needed blank to get out of his suit of armor. Finish, Brett. Richard's finished.
Oh, thank you. See how good he is in his heart.
Okay.
Even though he did steal Fanny Flagg's earring.
Robin, Sir Lancelot ate so much at the royal banquet he needed blank to get out of his suit of armor.
Oil.
Oil? Mm-hmm. She says oil. Grease him up a little bit and get him out of his armor. Brett, what do you say?
Everybody I know has been greased up for years. I said help.
Help to get out of his suit of armor.
Well,
need one
right.
To tie, two to win, Robin. And Joyce.
Oh, I said that he needed a jacksaw. Is there such a thing?
Hacksaw.
Hacksaw.
It's a loser anyway.
That's like
Richard.
President Arthur's
you
favorite
must
tool.
You Richard to stay in the game, Robin. What do you say, Richard?
I said help, darling.
Help.
Yeah.
Well, I'm sorry. So Michael Herbs wins the game. Congratulations. Come on down. Robin, we've got to say goodbye to you, but you're not going to be leaving empty-handed because you have, to your credit at this moment, a total of $5,600. Goodbye, Robin. All right, we'll get back to you in a moment. Now this for you. Gene Rayburn, Match Game 74. See you next time. Bye.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 74. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.
This is Match Game 74, production number 0183. Air date to be announced, VTR 32974.
Get ready to match the stars. Alan Ludden. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Joyce Bulifant. Richard Dawson. And Fannie Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
Brett is not ready.
That's gone funny. Have you noticed?
Well, I heard they were going to do a remake of Gone with the Wind.
Yes.
So I had Edie fix my hair this way.
Looks pretty.
Does she look like Marianne Mobley to you?
No, I look like Vivian Lee in the good days.
You look like Clark
after
Gable
the fire.
On a bad day,
right? What did you say?
He said you look like Clark Gable on a bad day.
You're so mean.
Truthful, too, darling.
He's sweet. He's okay. Well, you look to me as if you're all ready. So we'll greet our celebrity over here on this side. Here's our current champ, Robin Barrett.
Yeah.
How are you, Robin? Robin won one game, and she's got $100 to her credit, and she's about to have a go at over $5,000.
Someone showed me a single-spaced typewritten list of all the celebrities who had been on Match Game, and it's a formidable list. Betty White, Burt Reynolds, Kitty Carlisle, Joe Garagiola, Steve Allen. You know, we had them all.
Stay tuned for more of That 70s Hour on GSN.
Everybody came and bowed and paid their respect and kissed my ring.
Today's consolation prizes are the Gemini All-Floor Sweeper by Bissell. Sweeps any surface you can walk on right up to the baseboard. No cords or attachments required from Bissell. And the Insigerator Hot Water Dispenser gives you 190-degree water at your kitchen sink like having a tea kettle always ready from Insigerator. And Profile, with its own great flavor from a special formula of cracked wheat and wheat germ, just right for toast. Profile, it's a matter of taste. There'll be more challenges to the stars when Match Game 74 continues in just a blank.
Hello there. Now, we're going to start another game. To do that, we've got to welcome a new player, and we do so with a great deal of pleasure. Here is Michael Herbs.
Thank you.
How are you, Michael?
Pretty good, Gene.
Where are you from?
From Los Angeles. I'm a local fella.
You are?
Yep.
Michael is a local fella from Los Angeles here. Tell us a little more about yourself.
Well, I'm a communications consultant for a Fortune 500 company, and married, have two kids. Yeah. Angela and Kenny, and they're probably watching. Angela's 9 and Kenny's 8.
Yeah.
How you guys?
Do they like this show?
Love it.
They watch it often?
They think you're the greatest.
Well.
Honey matches.
Well, I thank you for that. Good luck to both of our players.
Want to say?
Yes.
Annie MacArthur.
Annie MacArthur.
Could be like Sam MacArthur or President MacArthur.
My dear friend B.
Okay.
MacArthur. All right. So you've got King Arthur, MacArthur, and President Arthur.
Now that's a great set of choices.
You've got 2.5 answers there. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own if you like, but we call for an answer now.
King.
All right. We are looking for King Arthur. May we see the $100 response, sir?
President B. Arthur.
That brilliant actress, B. Arthur, who plays Maud. And a friend of yours, yes. All right, we're still looking for King Arthur. Is he under the $250 response?
President.
No, MacArthur is, though. That's the one that Joyce gave you. Very good. Well, you're getting close, so this may be it. Hold on to your hat. Ready? All right. King Arthur, Sir Lancelot here calling. Are you under the $500 response?
Yes.
They think of the President Arthur.
I don't know. That audience was
They've never been to Seattle.
That's right. Okay, so it's King Arthur it is for $500 for you. That means you're now playing for 10 times that amount or $5,000. Now, to collect the $5,000, you must match one celebrity head-to-head. It has to be an exact match. Choose one now if you please.
Richard.
Richard again gets ready to write. You face me. Here is the $5,000 question, Richard. Happy blank. Happy blank. All right, he's finished. Now we want to know how you fill in that blank. Happy blank.
Birthday.
You say birthday? Okay, the audience seems to think that that is a good choice. We'll find out if you match Richard now by asking him to expose his card. May we see your response, sir, for $5,000?
There's a big hit TV show. Yeah, called Happy Days, which was, of course, before I was born. So I wrote Born Day or Birthday.
Beautiful. doctor friend, and there's your mother. They're all very happy for you. Her whole family's here. We congratulate you, Robin. You now have a total of $5,600, and in a moment or so, you'll play another game after we pass along this message of interest to one and all. Here it is.
GSN presents...
in our Big Money Super match here. Are you ready for that?
I sure am.
Okay, we'll do that right after we do a little business with you, so you stick around for that. Here we go. Robin Barrett, let's see how you're going to do here now in the Big Money Super match. You know how this goes. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank Arthur. Now, the answer that audience gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250. If you match that bottom one, you get $100. A little help is allowed from our celebrities. Choose three, one at a time.
Richard.
Richard Dawson, how do you fill that in there?
King Arthur.
King Arthur, he says.
To the king.
To the king.
Let's fight the Avalon.
All right, sir. Don't get carried away.
Yeah,
he is
about
British,
to do the speech.
You know. All right.
Alan.
Alan, what's his name?
After King, President.
Queen.
Let's try President Arthur.
President? Who was President Arthur?
Well, he was president of the Rotary Club in Seattle.
Poor Betty White, I never thought I'd feel sorry for her.
That's your answer, President Arthur.
No, I can't. Not only that, he voted for her.
Me, I was so convinced it was King Arthur.
Yeah.
I haven't got a Lord Arthur.
I'm afraid that won't wash, Alan.
Yes, sir. President.
Okay, President Arthur is the answer that we have to go with, and that's it. All right, one more.
Kinds of Arthur.
Joyce.
Oh, I'm so glad you asked me because I have two children named Mary MacArthur and Charles MacArthur, so I have to go with MacArthur. Well, as in general, not Mary and Charles, but
MacArthur is what you want.